Hello everyone, it's me, Andrea. Today I will show you an art journal page I made. Here you can see me preparing the page with gesso. And the next thing I show is the texture I will put down later into the middle. And this is actually sort of fabric for bookbinding, you know, for the spine. I really like to use it for texture. It's really nice. So now I get some paint down on the page very loosely. I won't cover the whole page. Only strike brush strokes from right to left with different green and turquoise tones. And at the end I will bring it together with a wet baby wipe. And the page I'm making is, I call it, it's a German title, Melancholie des Sommers. That means melancholy, do you say melancholy? Melancholy of the summer. You know, we had it quite hot here. And it's this feeling I get, you know, in the summer when it's so hot. After a while, it paralyzes you and it gives you this heaviness. And I'm not mean it in a negative way, because I quite like that. Everything is slower, everything is quieter, you know, and that's what I try to get on this page. So here I put this gauze type stuff down with heavy gesso, and what I do, I boil it with my heat gun to get even more texture on it. It's the most simple way to get texture on something, and you have it dried so much quicker, because the heavy gesso is really, really takes a long time to dry. Here I show you the embossing powder. It's the reason, because I needed a special red tone and I couldn't find it. I had three or four different reds, but nothing was the right one. So I mixed something and I got the right right color I wanted. I used this starfish. It's from Design by Rin and from her Sea Creatures, and when I heat emboss them afterwards, I cut them out. They go on the page later. So the next step is I will colorize them. That's a spectrum noir pencil in pinkish. That's a light pink. I only use that, nothing more, to get these white spots a bit colorized. Too white, left too white. So this is dried now, and I use different yellows and oranges and a bit of beige to get this part as the sand beachy part. And I will change that afterwards a bit more. That's too orange and a bit more yellow. And so I will put some that calls aquafine on top. It is something like clear gesso or absorbent ground. This one, it's a primer where you get tooth back on the page. I put it on loosely, very randomly, not completely. I don't cover it completely, because I wanted to have some acrylic ink drippage. I should have some grip, some tooth down there, and that's why I did that. Different yellows and oranges as well. Let it drip and force it up and down or right and left with my heat gun. And then at the end, I use again some gesso to tone it down a bit. Shouldn't be so bold. So, and here I stamped this starfish with paint, with the same green paint. Oh, I smeared a bit here, so I had to take it off. That's easy done. It's always a nice thing when you paint with when you stamp with paint. So, and this is this gold mica flakes. Quite like that stuff a lot. It is this flakes actually mixed in a medium. So when you put that on, it dries clear afterwards, and you will always see the flakes. So in this thickness I put it down. It takes quite a long time to dry, actually. So while that has to dry, I drew some beach huts or beach houses down, very sketchy, and colorized them here with different water-based pens, Distress, and afterwards I'd use the Tumbos, everything in greens and turquoises and purple on the top. Yeah. So going back with a black marker, and I have to cut them out. It's always the boring bit. I'm not showing it completely, don't I? No, God, thanks God I don't. So that's put loosely down to have a look where it looks best. And I stamp with white acrylic paint with the script stamp. And now I glue it down on the dunes. That's why what that should be, sort of sand dunes. So. And yeah, the starfish, you know, the starfish in German called Seestern, sea star. So that's why I'm always trying to say that. No, starfish, the starfish. So put it down, glued it down. So, and this is, oh, that's a stamp set I quite like. I think that was a giveaway from some magazine. I can't remember, but I really like this three stems as a texture on an art journal page. I stamped that down with the same dark green paint I have left over there. And afterwards I go into the rings with the white Sharpie. That gives really a nice contrast. But now I go around the houses and give some texture around the houses to make them pop more. And inside I have to put a bit of light into the windows, a bit of shading with a white pit pen. So in here you can see me putting the white Sharpie down into the circle structures. I like to do this in that way, it makes them pop really nicely. And while I did that, I thought it would look nice to have some of the dots in that starfish made solid with a Sharpie. So, and of course my Stabilo All I have to use to shade around the starfish a bit. Afterwards I use the water to activate it. And yeah, you can see me doing it here. And I think that's basically it. A bit of shading here and there, of course. Put some shades down next to the houses as well. First, I use the Sharpie again. A bit of white reflections here and there. And this is the shading. In my fantasy, the sun is already low. And this is the title, Melancholie de Sommers. And I think that's basically it. You will see a close-up now. And at the end, of course, you will see some pictures as well. And I say thank you for watching. I hope you liked it. And I will see you with my next video. So have a nice time, guys. Bye-bye.